It's like the dot-com era. You just had to be there. Some refer to it as the disruption of the fourth industrial revolution. Welcome to the age of AI. The recent popularity of AI has seen a great deal of coverage, including a lot of misleading and exaggerated content, the most obvious being ChatGPT. In this video, we'll talk about large language models like GPT, the different niches being carved out in this new space, and which of these AI tools may be more applicable to you. The race for the best AI tech service is on, and several big players are staking their claims in innovative ways. At the end of this video, you'll find out which ones really matter. If you're ready, then I am. Let's dive in right away. If I told you to list AI tech services you've used or heard of, you could probably come up with only a handful. What if I told you there are several hundred such services, and the number keeps growing rapidly? In order to navigate this topic in a digestible manner, we'll have to divide this AI services into three tiers. We'll go through them one by one and you can see which ones align more with your needs. Tier 1, the foundation models, often called large language models or LLMs. These are AI models that are trained on vast amounts of data, in this case, text. These models come from heavily funded labs and big tech firms like Google or OpenAI. They have billions of dollars to spend building these models, which achieve unbelievable results when they're released. It could take several months just to train one of these models. The very first LLM with current transformer technology was released by Google. Ever since, there have been other big companies following suit. This is where OpenAI's GPT series falls. Foundation models were initially open source to the public in the past, and this helped speed up progress in LLMs. However, as these large language models started to get really good, these giant AI labs started to amend policies surrounding the openness of these models. The worry of misinformation spreading using AI, coupled with bias and racist undertones in these programs, triggered a realignment in the industry. OpenAI only started to make their models available through APIs, moving away from the open source approach. You couldn't get full developer access to the code. Other companies like Hugging Face are trying to steer the ship back in the direction of open sourcing these important models to developers, and not just making them accessible through an API call. On one hand, there are people cheering for making these powerful models available to everyone to prevent the consolidation of power among only a few entities. On the other hand, companies are worried about what will happen if anyone could use these models without any restrictions. The blowback would definitely be on them. I'll talk about some of these LLMs shortly. I'll leave links in the description to resources for these very powerful AI models, some of which are open sourced, and some of which you'll have to shell out a few bucks a month for. Bloom, the largest open multilingual model, is one of the highlights on this tier. It can generate text in 46 natural languages and 13 programming languages. And all of this is free to the public. Meta also has a similar LLM, but the full version is only made available to researchers in the field. There are several foundation models I haven't mentioned here. This is where I urge you, Beyonders, to add to the comment section about LLMs I missed so that it may benefit others. On to the second tier. Tier 2 is where most of the fun begins. This is where the AI models are fine-tuned for specific use cases like dialogue, translations, or writing code, just to name a few. This is where ChatGPT resides. Because LLMs are trained on huge amounts of data, they have a general understanding of the structure of words. Fine-tuning is a special way of training a model for a specific use case, building on the knowledge of the foundation model. It's like the famous quote, "Jack of all trades, master of none." These fine-tuned models are really masters in their craft. ChatGPT from OpenAI and Sparrow from DeepMind are examples of this. They are trained on how human dialogue works, so they are very efficient at talking like humans while providing assistance to every request you make. Some of these finely tuned models are built by large tech firms that decide to release high quality fine-tuned versions of their foundation models. However, other AI labs and teams of much smaller capacity also release such models because the funding requirements aren't as steep. This is where several companies are beginning to stake their claim. Tier 1 in this AI gold rush are the gold miners, and tier 2 are the refiners. The miners discover the raw power and elegance of these models, and the refiners work on them to create products that are a bit more consumer-facing and pleasing to have. I previously mentioned Sparrow from DeepMind, which is a contender to OpenAI's ChatGPT. It was released a few weeks before ChatGPT, but its access was never made public, and that's why mainstream media never heard of it. With the way things are going, it's only a matter of time before Google integrates it into its popular search service to compete with Microsoft. Whether it's for safety reasons or to make money, Deciding when to release these models is a tricky decision. The competition among these companies is so fascinating to follow. It's like a cliffhanger on your favorite TV show. You just never know what might happen. I talked about the top 5 AI labs of 2023 in another video. I'll share the link in the description so you have a sense of how they're all connected. Another popular AI tool on this tier is Character.ai, a chatbot website that generates human-like responses. It was created by former Google developers. Users create and customize their own characters with specific personalities that help with creative writing or a text-based adventure game. You can chat with one character or in groups with multiple characters. Character.ai is one of the few tools on this tier that is built directly for your regular consumer. Adept AI Labs is also one of the important labs working on a digital assistant that can do any task on your computer. I also discussed this previously on the channel. All links will be shared below, so you have a ton of material to go through. The goal of Adept is to get your AI assistant to book flights or Airbnb stays, perform calculations in Excel, or simply surf the internet based on simple text instructions. There are other labs like Inflection AI also working on this, and I'm hoping these labs will release the beta versions to the public sometime this year. A model that is a great mesh of these types of digital assistants and state-of-the-art models like ChatGPT or Character.ai will be eerily similar to the movie Her, and I can't wait. Or maybe I can, considering the ending of the movie. It'll honestly make our lives easier in so many aspects.
Mr. Theodore Twombly, welcome to the world's first artificially intelligent operating system, OS1. We'd like to ask you a few basic questions before the operating system is initiated. This will help create an OS to best fit your needs.
Okay.
Are you social or antisocial?
I guess I haven't really been social in a while. Mostly because...
In your voice, I sense hesitance.
Are you leaving me?
There's obviously the overdependence and attachment factor that may arise from such scenarios, but that's a topic we can discuss another day. Many influential co-founders and entrepreneurs are heavily invested in this gold refiner stage. There have been several workers who've left very large organizations or some of the influential AI companies because of the huge growth potential. You can see there has been some sort of reshuffle of high-quality talent in the last few years. Let's go through some examples. We'll do a quick walkthrough. Tier 2 has applications that are easier to understand to non-developers. These can be accessed by an API or a playground interface, like here in the GPT 3.5 environment. This is the same model that runs ChatGPT. So if you're looking for a more chat-style approach, then you can use ChatGPT instead. It might be a bit technical, but definitely not as technical as Tier 1. So we want to write a story here in the playground. We'll try the same thing in ChatGPT. And as you can see, the output is pretty similar. Cohere is another Tier 2 type of service that uses fine-tuned versions for dialogue. Let's put the same piece of text here and see what happens. So this one is a bit different. It doesn't give us a script format like in GPT. It gives us a narrative storytelling format. I actually love this story. This is actually great. This next one, Character.ai, has a very fascinating website. We briefly talked about this. You're able to create characters you want to talk to, or you can use user-generated ones. You could create a room and the room would have different characters in it, just like your WhatsApp group or iMessage group chat. So this is quite interesting. And after interacting with it, I can see why it's easy to get addicted to. I have an example here talking with Harry, and honestly, I could have kept going for a few more minutes. The group chats are even more fun. The difference between Character.ai and others, and the reason why people love it, is that it's less filtered. And so characters are more expressive compared to ChatGPT. There has been recent backlash from users on the platform because they're finding out that the answers are being filtered now, and so the characters are not expressing themselves as they were in the beginning. Alright, moving along. Finally, there's Replica. Similar to Character.ai, once you create your characters, you're able to have conversations with them. The third and final tier are the jewelers of the gold rush. Their products are made directly to the consumer. It's where most of the low-hanging fruit opportunities are. They take existing models like the foundation or fine-tuned models and transform them into products that are easy to use for the everyday consumer. No need to understand technical jargons or curate prompts. This is where most AI text users fall. These services usually connect to API endpoints provided by some of the AI labs we previously mentioned. The first two tiers are usually still too complex for the layperson. For example, websites like Jasper or Quillbot provide readily available websites you can interact with for generating or summarizing text. These websites make requests to the APIs mentioned earlier. The companies have curated prompts that can properly elicit the best results for you. AI marketing startups like Copy AI will provide the best marketing copy for you based on your specifications. These specifications are then sent to the Tier 2 endpoints before your copy is generated. ChatGPT is currently limited in its internet access and also lacks in factual accuracy, and therefore there have been several services that have come up trying to solve this need. Some of these companies like Perplexity and YouSearch do a great job at this. You can search exactly the same way you would search on Google or ChatGPT and get the answers immediately. The benefit of this approach is that you get the quick availability of answers like ChatGPT while also having a factual record of the information provided. The idea of combining results from a chatbot with several other sources is quickly becoming the most reliable way of using AI chat services. You can follow up on previous queries, which makes the search a bit more engaging. Programming libraries like LangChain make this kind of quick calls to endpoints very easy. This approach is called chaining, a fitting term to our jeweler analogy. You can chain several sources of information before providing the final output to the user. It's obvious why this approach is more appealing to customers. A few layers removed from too much technical know-how, a few mouse clicks, and then boom, you get extremely good results. This opens possibilities where companies can provide very customized offerings to clients. They find a niche that the user might be interested in, find relevant documents or API endpoints for that niche, and then program a website to make calls to a chain of endpoints to help the user. One good example is Jasper. Jasper is a very popular tool that helps in article writing and helps you generate AI art. Jasper is well known in the industry and a lot of people rely on it to write blogs. So if you have a creative blog or you're just looking for fresh ideas, you can start with Jasper. I'll leave the link in the descriptions below and you can check it out. There are other services like Quillbot or Copy AI you can check out on your own time. Amazing AI tools as well. I hope this Tier 3 approach gives you more information to decide which apps might be better suited for your needs. I'll leave all AI tools discussed today and then some more in the descriptions. Whether you're an entrepreneur who's looking for a niche AI solution or a user looking to fast track your work pipeline, these tools will be very helpful in the next few years. Some of the links are affiliate links, and for those ones, if you end up buying the product, I get a small commission which helps me continue this work I'm doing. Thanks in advance and thanks for watching. If you're looking for interesting AI news no one else is covering, this is the place to be. Remember to subscribe to the channel for frequent AI updates. Until the next video, it's goodbye.